ओके, सो टुडे व्हाट वी विल लर्न अबाउट इज द मूवमेंट ऑफ बोन्स. द बॉडी मूवमेंट्स आर द रिजल्ट ऑफ बोन्स एंड मसल्स वर्किंग टुगेदर. सो वी ऑल नो दैट मसल्स आर जस्ट बाउंड टू द बोन्स और दे आर कनेक्टेड टू द बोन्स बाय सम स्पेशल स्ट्रक्चर्स और बैंड लाइक टिश्यूज. दे आर कॉल्ड टेंडन्स, राइट? These tendons contract and relax. Contract means they expand by their size, and relax means again they come back to their previous size. So this contraction and relaxation of tendons, they help in the movement of our bones. Muscles can only pull the bones by contracting. So when the muscles contract, it pulls the bone. They cannot push. So to move the bones in one direction, at least two muscles are required. One that will contract and another that will relax. For example, the up and down movements of our arms are controlled by two muscles, biceps and triceps. You must have heard about these muscles. So biceps and triceps are two different types of muscles that controls the upward and downward movement of our arms. When you want to raise your arm, the biceps in front become shorter, that means they contract and pull up the arm. To lower the arm, the triceps at the back, they contract and pull the arm downward. So when you want to pull the arm in the upward direction, the bicep muscles contract. And when you again need to pull the arm downwards, then the triceps muscles contract. When the bicep muscles contract, then the triceps muscles relaxes. And when the triceps muscle contract, then the bicep muscles relaxes. This is how they control the movement of our arms. One picture is also given here that shows us how the bicep and triceps muscles work. Now let's read about X-ray. Sometimes when we are hurt, doctors take an X-ray photograph of the injured part to find out whether there is any fracture in the bones. X-rays are special rays that can pass through soft tissues, but not through the bones. Therefore, an image is created that reveals the nature of the bones. These bones are seen as white shapes against a black background. So X-rays are special types of rays that can pass through our muscles, but that cannot pass through the bone. As the ray cannot pass through the bone, so we can see a white colored shadow type of image of the bone. If there is any fracture or any crack in the bone, that can also be seen by the X-ray. This is why doctors prefer to take an X-ray photograph if we go to them with any fracture or crack in our bones. So by doing the X-ray or by taking the X-ray photograph, they can easily tell us exactly where the fracture is and how much harmful or dangerous is that, and what treatment we should do for that kind of fracture.
Now, how do you understand that where the fracture is happened?
Yes, for that you will have to see these pictures. Go to the next page. There you can see some pictures are given here. The first one is the picture of the chest. It's an X-ray plate. These plates are called X-ray plates. So what you can see in this X-ray plate? Can you see the ribcage?
Ma'am, yes,
why,
ma'am?
But we cannot see the lungs. We cannot see the lung. We cannot see the heart. Those are also present there, right? These organs are also present there.
But X-ray machine, they don't take the photo of the lungs and the livers and the kidneys or all the things.
Because those are soft tissues. And as I have told you before, that X-ray, the ray can pass through the soft tissues, but it cannot pass through the bones. This is why, so as it has got stopped by the bones of the rib cage, we can see only the rib cage here. Here in this picture, we can see only the bones of the hand. We cannot see the muscles and the tissues of the hands here. Here you can see the jaws. We can see the bones only. And here we can see the pelvis only. So if any fracture is there, it will be, suppose if any in this hand, if any bone is broken, we can easily see that. If we can see the bone, then if the bone is broken, we can be it can also be seen here. And these plates are called X-ray plates. Now the movements in animals. So the first animal that is given here is the earthworm. So let's see what is written here. The body of an earthworm is made up of many rings joined end to end. An earthworm does not have bones. It has muscles which help to extend and shorten the body. During the movement, the earthworm first extends the front part of its body and keeping the rear portion fixed to the ground. Then it fixes the front part of its body and pulls the rear end. That means, you see this picture. So what does it do? First of all, it extends the first half of its body. It extends it and keeps this rear portion, means the left portion. That means the second half of its body, it keeps it attached to the or fixed to the ground. And then when it extends the front side of its body, then what does it do? It fixes this front part to the ground and pulls this part towards the front part. Okay. So as in this picture, this is the head here. That means this is the front part. So what it will do? It will extend the front part and it will fix the rear part to the ground. After extending the front part, it will just contract the front part and fix it to the ground and then pull the backside of its body to the front part. This is how very slowly it will move on the ground.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Earthworm have eye.
Who is this? Tell me your name. Roaches have six legs, three pairs of legs or six legs. The leg muscles provide the movement for walking and climbing. Their body is covered with a hard outer skeleton. This outer skeleton is made up of different units that are joined together and that allows their movement. They have a pair of antenna. So can you see the antenna, a pair of antenna here in this picture?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
One antenna and second antenna. So these are the two antenna that they have. These antenna help them to sense anything, to get the feeling whether anything is, any other insect or anything is coming towards them. Any kind of feeling they can feel through this antenna. And they have three pairs of legs. You can see one, yes, two, three. At each side, three legs. That means total six legs.
Ma'am, abdomen
moving. This part is of their body. This is called the abdomen. That means whatever they eat, that goes directly there to get digested. Okay?
Ma'am, like our liver.
Okay, ma'am.
Not, liver is not the abdomen. Liver is another part. Abdomen is another part. Liver secretes the bile, the juices, digestive juices that helps to digest the food. And abdomen helps to absorb the nutrients from the food. Okay? And you can see the head also here. The head part of the cockroach. Now let's see how they move. You already know that the cockroaches, breathe through.
Eyes.
Yes. And tell me, students, the part of their body through which they breathe, cockroaches breathe through?
Ma'am, nose.
They are insects. Oh, they have spiracles. Can you remind it? Spiracles?
Yes,
small holes.
Yes, the insects that breathe through the spiracles. That means tiny holes present in their body. and they also have a pair of wings attached to the breast, and the breast muscles move the wings when the cockroach flies. Cockroach also walks in a very unique manner by moving three legs at a time. So they can move three legs at a time, and this is how they move, and they can also fly, and their wings are attached to the breast muscles, and the breast muscles help to move the wings. So this is how.
But ma'am, cockroaches not fly. Ma'am, so much ma'am, they usually walk.
No, ma'am. They usually walk, but cockroaches can fly also.
Cockroaches can fly.
Not the baby cockroaches, but the mature one can fly.
I will stick.
Ma'am, I see that one yellow cockroach is there. The yellow cockroach was flying yesterday.
Yes, yes. I have also seen, and yes, generally they walk. They prefer walking.
Yes, but ma'am. Not too much fly.
They can fly. Also, if they get frightened, then they will.
Ma'am,
also
we will throw out. He will fly.
Yes. So now let's see this yes, part. Ma'am. Movement in a fish. Movement in a fish.
Like a parrot,
the body of
ma'am.
A fish is specially designed for swimming. Its body is broader in the middle and narrow at the ends. As we all know, the basic fish structure, that is they have a streamlined body, right? Like this. That is the body that is broader in the middle section and narrower at both ends. So this type of structure is called streamlined body. And this is why we call that fishes also have this type of streamlined body. This shape allows the water to move easily around the body and offers the least resistance to its flow. So this type of body of fishes, they help the fishes to swim inside the water. Fishes have fins and a flexible backbone that can help in swimming. Most fishes have a special structure called swim bladder that can be filled with air and emptied to help them move up and down in water. Now, how many of you have seen the air bladder inside a fish's body? Have you seen an air sac or a bag-like structure?
Yes, ma'am.
Like this, a bag-like structure inside the fish's body? Yes, so what is the function of that structure? That is called swim bladder. So what is the name of that structure? That is called swim bladder. And fishes can, as they want, they can put air into that bladder and they can take the air from that bladder. When they put, when they fill the bladder with air, what happens then? If the bladder is filled with air, exactly like balloon, it becomes lighter by weight, right? And so the fish can go in the upward direction. It can float in water. It can go in the upward direction. And when the fish needs to go to the downward direction into the water, then it takes away all the air from the bladder. So what happens? The weight of the fish increases, and then the fish becomes heavy, and then it easily goes to the downward direction into the water. So by controlling the air present inside the swim bladder, fishes can move in the upward and downward direction into the water. The body of fishes is covered with scales. Fishes move with the help of their tails. In order to move forward, the fish moves its tails from side to side. This propels the fish forward. So for upward and downward direction, to move in the upward and downward direction, fishes use their swim bladders present inside their body. They fill it with air, and again they take out all the air present inside the bladder. And to move in the front side, front and backward direction, to move in the front, forward and backward direction, they use their tails and the backbone also, the soft backbone that they have, that backbone, their fins and tails, these are used for moving in the forward and backward direction. Movement in birds. This is the last part of this page. Birds are most common flying animals. You all know how birds move. What is
yes,
the
ma'am.
part, what is their body part that helps them in flying?
Ma'am,
wings.
Yes,
wings,
their wings are covered with feathers, right? They
yes,
have
ma'am.
A streamlined body too. So just like fishes, birds also have a streamlined body. You can see this picture. In this picture, you can see the body of the bird. It's streamlined, right? That means
ma'am, too many noises are coming.
Yes, then mute your device, students.
Aryan.
Broader in the middle section and narrower at both ends. So this body is also streamlined body, which helps them to move through the air. They beat their wings against the air to propel forward. You can see how they move just beat by beating their wings in the forward, upward and downward direction to move forward. The bones of the birds are also hollow. That means from the inside they are hollow. They have air spaces that makes the bird's body weight very light, making it easy for them to rise in the air. Strong muscles that are present in their breastbones or around their breastbones that help to bird to flap their wings and fly. Flapping the wings means moving the wings, that is called flapping the wings. Yes, exactly, Shabaz, as you are showing, that is the correct way of flapping the wings. Very good.
Ma'am,
so
I have
this is
how... that.
Yes, so yes, Srijan, I have seen that. So they also, you must have seen, Srijan, that they flap their wings. To fly, they flap their wings. So by flapping the wings, they can easily fly in the air. So that's it, everyone. Mark up to this.
Ma'am, one
page is not complete.
No, one page is left. Ma'am, so small.